Man, I can finally say with good conscience that I found an overshoe that will last me for a pretty long time. And I finally found my solution. I finally found the overshoe that really lives up to its reputation. We are talking about the Spatz, or I don't know how you pronounce it, Spatz. Roadman 2, amazing overshoe. The Roadman 2, of course they also have other models, like a little more shorter model, a bit more lightweight, I think, a bit thinner. But then they also have really hardcore overshoes that are really warm. But let's talk about the Roadman 2, because I've been testing it for a few days now. Now, I'm not sponsored by Spatz. I had to wait a really long time and pay quite a lot of money for them to finally get my hands on one of these, because they only produce in small batches. Here it says made in Cambodia. I think their supplier just can't produce large numbers at a time. I don't know if this has anything to do with the Suez Canal sort of shipments are really stopped at the moment. But let's talk about the characteristics of this Roadman 2. Now, I wanted to go with the Roadman Pro in the first place because I really wanted this hardcore overshoe for commuting and riding in the winter, because I like to ride a lot and I don't really want to pay attention to the weather. I just want to go out and ride. I'm sure a lot of you can relate to this. But then I went for the Roadman 2 because, well, that was the only one that was available, and so it basically just covers your leg almost up to your knee, which is really amazing, because if you rode in really, really wet conditions, a lot of rain, hard rain, you notice that your legs are really beginning to be wet up to your knees, really. So this is really cool, I thought. Of course it looks a bit special. It's a bit it's not like your regular overshoe, because it's first of all so long. Then you have those like reflective stripes at the back, which are great, by the way. And then this really unconventional really design, and also this tip in the front. This is like a reinforced for the toes, and also here for the feet bones. Not really sure how you call it that, actually. And then on the bottom here, you can just open it up like this. You have this, you can close it down here like this. So this means you can put them on before putting on your shoes and then closing them, which is really great. So you don't have to put on your shoes and then go through this long and annoying process of getting your overshoe over your shoe. You can just basically have it on like that, and you just really cover it over like that. It's so really simple. I paid about like $100 in Swiss francs, which is pretty much because I had it shipped from the UK. Depends on where you ship it in the world, the price can vary. I have done some really hard testing on those in heavy rain and also a bit of cold. But I have really to stress that this Roadman 2 is really for temperatures that are really below 8 degrees Celsius, because if you go over 10 and you go you have like a high cadence, then you pretty soon begin to accumulate heat and really begin to sweat. Because I will show you the inside of the overshoe. You have this shin protection in the front that really is like a thermo interlaying that protects it from the wind and from the cold. So it's really a great shoe for the winter. I'm sure that in the winter it will do really well with temperatures around the freezing point. And man, am I glad I finally found such great overshoes, because I'll show you two other overshoes I had been using since a long time, especially those Garnier overshoes. Now Garnier is a shoe manufacturer, and of course they also wanted to do some overshoes. Now those are great, actually, if you have a light rain and a bit of wind, but they don't really protect you from the cold because they are so thin, unbelievably thin. You could almost think this is an aero overshoe for like time trials or things like that. And you see they also use pretty quickly. This material isn't really sturdy, but it's nice and stretchy. it's not really hard to put on, but hard rain, they only last you like 30 minutes, and then your shoes, your feet and your socks will be really wet. Then I have used some Gore overshoes, the Windstopper edition. Now those are great against wind and cold. Against the wet, they are not bad. Like, I never really had wet feet, but I never rode them in heavy rain either. And in the cold also, like 1 hour, 90 minutes, really the max time you can do at the freezing point, then you will just have cold toes again. But with those, I believe all my problems are solved. They too do stretch quite nicely. Those are really like a neoprene. The material really is like neoprene, like those diving suits that you can get. And putting those on for your commute or heavy rain riding is really nice. You just feel like your feet are resting on a couch, really. They are nicely tucked in and warm. I really like riding in the rain a lot now, really. I liked it before, but I just always took it for granted that I will be wet anyways. Really to my skin, because I knew I didn't have the clothes that will protect me from the wet. But now I have those, they protect really, really well from the rain. I actually didn't have a single drop coming in, not even from the top, you know, if it rains really heavy. And also, some people have been asking me if you have closed them on the bottom like this, if those are the weak spots, like the water coming from below, probably from the street, if it really kicks up the rain a lot. No, I actually haven't felt any rain coming from below, and the shoes, of course, they were a bit wet below, but they really cover it greatly. Also, they have this anti-slipping like cover here that really grips the shoe really greatly and really holds on tightly. I read a review on their website, and one guy said, believe the hype, and I just can't say any more but to subscribe to that comment and say have a nice evening to you. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next one.